Hello, everyone. I'm Gary DeLaune. On November 13th, 1980, one of the finest high school football games in San Antonio history was played at Northside Stadium before a record crowd of 14,500 fans. Holmes won the game 24-22, but it left the thousands limp with excitement. Following, a taped broadcast of that game.
And fumbled, and I believe Santiago falls on it at the 34-yard line as they tried the squib kick, keeping it away from the speed as Santiago fell on it. Danny Garza it was.
Gary, the official time will be kept on the field tonight by Ken Dugas. Problems with the clock, as they pointed out, so the official time will be kept on the field. We'll keep you up to date on that.
First and 10 at the 33-yard line. Garza, Santiago, Beverly, and Cole. And we go out of the wing T formation for the J Mustangs. Here's the snap and the handoff. Straight up the middle, and it goes to Anthony Beverly. Crosses the 35 to the 38, the 40-yard line. And to the 43, close to the first down. Jimmy Hawkins, the all-district free safety man, made the stop. But that's a 9-yard pickup. This quarter is brought to you by Satops, where they're having their once-a-year tent sale. Everything's got to go, so go on by 1134 West Hildebrand.
Gary, we're going to have a measurement here on the sidelines. We're on the Holmes bench side, and Jay is trying for the first down of the ball game. Here is the stretch of the chain by referee John Barnett. It is good by half the length of the football.
Quick opener, great holes opened by Bowman, Clay, and Clay. It's Curtis Clay on the right side, Ray Clay on the left side. And they opened a giant hole. You could have driven Junior Sample through it. Gain of 10, first and 10, the first down of the ball game. Northside Stadium, Gary DeLaune, Barry Robinson, Greg Simmons with Andy Poland standing by at Alamo. Again, it's the wing tee, the handoff again to Anthony Beverly. This time, Anthony can go absolutely no place. At the bottom of that stack is James Robertson, the defensive right end, 6'3", 180-pounder, along with John Bruni, a 5'11", 180-pound senior. So they combine to make the stop, a gain of 2, maybe a long one, second and 9.
On that same play, Jay gained 10 yards a play before. I guess they figured they'd go ahead and work it till Holmes stopped it. Holmes did make the defensive adjustment and tightened up inside.
Haiti was caught out of position that first play, but that time he was there to help out the tackle. It's now 4-3, and they bring up almost a five-man front. Here's the turn. Here's the reverse, and it comes to the first man through. And who is it? The guy. It's Staten. Comes to the 45, the 50, then the 45, and gets down to the 33-yard line. Tony Staten. Stopped by John Bruni. So Staten turns on the jets, and quickly, with Ormiston out front blocking, the big kid that's 6'5", 242, only 16 years old, he didn't play last year, bringing up first and 10 at the 34-yard line. Santiago has checked back in, and going out is Tony Staten as they will shuttle back and forth. Time will be kept on the field. Clock is not functioning tonight. At the 34, first and 10 for the J Mustangs. They're on the march. They have the stampede. Here is a fake, and it goes to Santiago, and he gets maybe a yard, and that's all. And there's Hawkins at the bottom of the stack, along with Donald Johnson at left linebacker, a 6'1", 185-pound senior. Coming into this game, the J offense, second in the city, 2,693 yards rushing, at 366 yards per game when you put the passing attack to it. Scored 33 points a game in 1980. Going out of the ballgame, Santiago, back in is Staten. A gain of a half yard, but call it one, second and 9. At the Holmes Husky 33-yard line, here is Danny Garza, the little guy. Here's the reverse, the same play. Comes to Staten to the left side. He's still on the 35, comes up out of the 33, and out of bounds about the 32-yard line. So smelling it out beautifully defensively was Danny Gonzalez. Over to make the stop and chase him out of bounds. It didn't work that time, Bear.
Sure it didn't. They tried again the same play on the sweep with Staten. Worked for 23 yards two plays earlier. I think Jay has the widest gaps between those offensive linemen, Gary, of any team we've seen this year. And, of course, with that much speed in the backfield, they're trying to get a bigger hole.
I wish you guys could be down here with me on the sidelines and trying to dodge me as he comes out of bounds. He's got so many moves, you can't figure out which way to move away from him.
Out of bottle they come. Wide to the right is Santiago. He's the wingman. Here's Garza back to pass. He wants to pitch. He decides to keep. He's down to the 30 and hit hard and rolls to the 27-yard line short of the first down. Hit by Javier Garcia, 5'10", 170-pound junior. And he grabbed the encampment and unloaded the guns that time as he pitched his tent defensively at the 28-yard line, fourth and 4. So this is a time of decision for Coach L.G. Henderson out of Phillips, Texas, who coached five state championship teams at Artesia, New Mexico. Took his Anos Coyotes to the state semifinals last year. And now he's got the J Mustangs battling for the district title. By the way, the district championships, five in baseball, seven in track, six consecutively for the Mustangs. Four girls basketball titles. Here they go. They're going to go fourth and four. Staten, the man in the hole at the right. Long count by Jay. Here's the handoff. It goes outside. It's to Cole. He tries to go to the 30, down to the 27. He stops short of the first down, I believe. Good pursuit as they shut him off at the pass. And making the stop, I believe it was Jeff Habe, along with Kevin Gutchess.
Yes, and it was Kevin Gutchess who forced the play, Gary, number 86 over there. He looked like a big old lineman. Good speed, though. He forced him out wide and just would not let him cut back upfield until he got the pursuit from the defense.
Big play, Barry, defensively. Offensively, here come the Huskies. Then a pitchback comes to Lawson. Lawson cuts outside. He's to the 25, to 30, and up to the 31-yard line. And he's met in the secondary by Scott Thomas. Now, let's give you the Holmes offense. Mike Frisky at one end. It'll be Joe Benugli, Gonzalez, Roland, Ted Gaynor at center. Shigai Ligon at right guard. Brad Westbrook at right tackle. Milton McKenzie. Then we've got Rene Maldonado at quarterback, Keith Austin, Greg Russell, and Calvin Chastang. Here we go. Out of the huddle they come. The pitch back to Maldonado. He gives it back to Lawson again. Lawson cuts to the outside. He turns the corner. He's at the 30. He's at the 35. And out of bounds at the 36-yard line. As Keith Lawson, the fifth-ranked rusher in the city, with a 7-yard average, is chased out of bounds over there by Fred Winiger and Richard Latta. So it's going to be third and one as the Holmes Huskies try to crank up their attack. They're barking now. They look out for the bite in the secondary. Coming in now with the lineup changes. Calvin Chastain coming in along with Clifford Wallace. Out of the huddle they come. Over the ball is Ted Gurner, the center. He is a 5'10", 175-pound senior. Full house backfield, almost like a wishbone. Here's the fake, and here's the handoff, and it goes to Lawson. He breaks it to the 40-yard line. First and 10 for the Holmes Huskies, making the stop. Over there is Roger Flores and Ed Solis.
We have a little under 8 minutes in counting as a first down was gained by the Holmes Huskies here. Their first down of the contest tonight against Jay.
Satoff's bringing you this first quarter. Load up your pickup and go down and see what they've got in their annual pen sale. Greg Russell is back in the lineup at fullback. Maldonado, the former all-district wide receiver, he wants to throw. He does. He's got a man, but it's incomplete. And over the outstretched hands of Scott Thomas, he almost had an interception. Also defending back there was Staten, intended for Calvin Chastang. Good speed, 5'9", 165-pound senior, has four receptions coming into the ball game. They don't pass much.
No, and as Coach Molesky pointed out prior to the game, chances are they will throw more in this game because they're such a good rushing team. Jay's going to stack up and try to stop the run.
Jerry Robinoff, wide to the right. Maldonado pitching it back, comes to Lawson. He's got an opening, but he can't go as he found the chip in the ice, but melting it over quickly from the left linebacker slot, Gerald Lawrence. 90 tackles coming into this game. The leading tackler for the Jay Mustangs, bringing up third and seven.
Gary and Jay, we just have a score here at Alamo Stadium. This is Andy Poland reporting. A 22-yard field goal by Manea Woods has put Sam Houston up on top, 3-0, and we have got 3 minutes and 17 seconds to play in the first quarter here at Alamo Stadium.
Thank you, Andy. We don't know how much time left here. Kept on the field. Here is Maldonado pitching it back to Lawson. He cuts inside and is hit at the line of scrimmage, and that's where he'll be buried. And making the stop is Anthony Beverly, a 6-foot, 190-pound senior. 10th ranked are the J Mustangs defensively, allowing 45 points all season. That's a 5-point average. 7 minutes left in the first quarter. No score.
And that sounds like an upset in the makings out there at Alamo. Highlands undefeated. Sam Houston lost big in its first three games of the season. Really came on, but still I think Highlands was a favorite tonight.
Jimmy Hawkins, the all-district booter, will be back to punt. And he'll kick from his own 32-yard line, speed to burn, waiting for it. He gets it away. Boy, what a beautiful, high, spiraling kick, and it's going to bounce. Thrown dead at the 1-yard line. Can you believe that? Oh, my land, what a boot. 55 yards and no return. That's why he's all district.
Yeah, that thing was controlled by radar, Gary. That thing hit a good 20, 25 yards inbound on about the 5, and it just took a 90-degree angle almost and went out of about the 1, 2-yard line.
Looked like a squeegee board. or a squeegee brush on a Ouija board, or a Ouija board with a squeegee brush. Here we go, first and go, first and 10 at the 1 yard line. The Jay Mustangs are always dangerous in this situation. Here's the keeper straight over his center, Mike Bowman, and that's Danny Garza on the keep. He's met by the front four of that big green-clad Holmes Husky defensive wall. Across there, you've got Bruni, Roberson, Galloway, and Riemann.
How's that for a punt, Gary? A 54-yarder that goes out of the one-yard line. Good gosh.
Great field position now for the Holmes Huskies defense. Can they hold the J Mustang? So volatile. Can explode at any moment. Here's the fake and the handoff, and there he goes. It's that's the throw to the 10, the 15, he's in the 20, the 25, the 30, the 35, the 40, he's in the 40, the 45, the 40, he's in the 35, the 30, he's in the 25, the 20, the 15, he's all the way in for a touchdown. Flag is down, Ansel Cole has gone 95 yards, but bring it back, maybe.
Gary, I cannot believe if that's the flag against the J Mustangs, Coach Henderson just might, you know, he might fall. That ball is on the flag is on the J 45, and it's 55 yards away from the end zone, and it fell about the time he was stepping into the end zone. No reason for it.
95 yards on the run. As we told you, they were so dangerous in that position if they got the step.
The flag was not against Jay, so the TD stood, the extra point was good, and the Mustangs opened up with a 7-0 lead over Holmes. Gary DeLaune picks up the play-by-play at the next kick.
Gary Molesky's 39, will be 40 next month. He said it would be great to celebrate his birthday with the district title, but he's got a long way to go right now. Trailing 7-0. 6 minutes under left here in the first period. And here's the boot, and waiting for it. It's Russell straight up the middle. He gets to the 15. It's Hawkins to the 20-yard line. He almost had a wave there, and if he'd had one more block, he could have perhaps had his own tied up touchdowns. Henrik Pardenas makes the stop. So it's first and 10 for the Holmes Huskies now, as they have suddenly seen a great kick go against them. A 55-yard kick with no return going out of the one, and then a 95-yard touchdown run by Ansel Cole. Here we go. Back to play as Chastang is split along with Mike McKenzie. Man under is Maldonado. He turns. He gives it off, and it comes to Russell. Russell comes to the 20, gets up to the 25, still on his feet to the 26-yard line. Hanging on for dear life is Anthony Beverly, the first guy to hit him along with Robert Santiago. Scott Thomas comes in to assist, but that's a big gain of 7 yards. It'll be second and 3. The Holmes Huskies, Garner, Ligon, or Ligon, I think it's Ligon, Shigai Ligon, Brad Westbrook, Milton McKenzie, Roland Gonzalez, and Joe Benugli, along with Mike Frisky, who is the big surprise for Gary Molesky. Wide to the left now goes Milton McKenzie. Here's the turn, the give, and it's straight up the middle to the fleet feet of Keith Lawson. He cracks over right tackle, right guard for a first down before Ansel Cole, rather Tony Staten, makes the stop. But it is a first down for the Holmes Huskies.
Gentlemen, we have an update here from Alamo Stadium. The Highlands Owls have just gone on top 7-3. They bottled up Jeff Crumity well in the first quarter, but on the first play of the second quarter, he rolled over about three defenders and raced 35 yards into the end zone, and the extra point by Sam Medina was good. And our score now, with 11 minutes 51 seconds to play in the first half, Highlands 7, Sam Houston 3.
Our score is 7-0 here. Here's the handoff, and again it goes to Russell, the big fullback, plowing his way, picking up plenty of secondary yardage. A 6-foot, 170-pound senior, averaging 6 yards, stopped by Santiago and Staten in the secondary. But again, a big 6-yard chew off the plug of the J Mustangs. Both teams can be gained on offensively.
Although this is the first quarter, still the first quarter, big series for Holmes. It has to get some first downs, keep the ball away from that J offense.
Here's Maldonado. He keeps, and he stopped at the line of scrimmage, and making the bear hug tackle from his defensive end position is Steve Kopp, a 5'10", 175-pound junior.
Gary, our official timer, Ken Dugas, tells us we have less than 4 minutes now to go in the first period of play. Less than 4 minutes with our score 7-0, Jay on top of Holmes.
Last year's score, 34-25, I believe. 9-point lead by Holmes in the last quarter, and Jay took it. And Gary Molesky says his boys remember that game vividly. Now that'll come, Calvin Chastang wide to the right. Maldonado. And there's an offside against Jay as he bumped the center, and that was Gerald Lawrence, I believe, or was it, Fred Winiger, the nose guard. Should be a 5-yard mark off, and that could be a first down. It is. First and 10 for the Huskies up to their 43-yard line. Andy Poland at Alamo Stadium, says the score is 7-3. Sam Houston trailing. Islands now after the Cherokees had gone on top early. Our score is 7-0. Left in the first period. Greg Simmons on the sideline. Barry Robinson, Gary DeLaune, Lou Houck, and Brent Silber keeping informed from press box side. Here's the fake in the reverse, and it comes to rather the counter, and it goes to Russell. He gets maybe 2 yards, that's all, making the stop. Nose guard Fred Winiger, a 5'9", 175-pound senior. Across that forward wall in that 52 defense of L.G. Henderson, they average 182 pounds a man. Offensively, it's 182 pounds for the Holmes Huskies, so that's tit for tat, even Steven. Muscle for muscle. Wide to the left, Milton McKenzie and Calvin Chastang in a tandem set. Maldonado turns, pitches it back. Strong side left. Here goes Lawson. Lawson cuts up down to the 45 to 50. He's down to the 45 and dives out of line for a first down of the 44-yard line. There he goes. Keith Lawson. He is a dandy. He clipped the edges and trimmed the rough.
Keith Lawson is one of those type runners that he runs as fast as he has to run. Then, the way he was running, Gary, I thought he might be tackled for a 2-yard gain, and all of a sudden, somebody pushed a button, and he just spurted out in front of everyone else, a big first down.
3 minutes left, 7-0, but here come the Huskies, full house backfield at the 45-yard line. Mustang territory, Maldonado keeps, rolls, 5 yards, maybe four. Good play, a little counter-option play. They'll run a lot of option, almost like the Houston Veer, making a stop, Beverly, and he's assisted by Mike Blake, 195-pound junior, with about 50 tackles coming into this ball game. A gain of four, second and six. Ball's at the 41-yard line, Jay territory. 2 minutes left in the ball game's first quarter. 7-0. John Jay at Alamo Stadium at Sam Houston, 3. Highlands, 7. Full house backfield again. The big green of Holmes on the move. Here's the counter, the option. Maldonado pitching a little down and in pattern, and it's complete. Great call by Mike Fischke. 6'3", 195-pound basketball star. Staten and Thomas make the stop.
A beautiful pass play. When you're a great running ball team, Gary, you can use that run, either way. You can fake to them, and in that case, they did, and the receiver was wide open. Actually, had it been a good pass that the ball had led the receiver, he might have been able to score.
Got a minute and a half left. Minute and a half left to go in the first quarter.
First and 10. Maldonado turns, gives it off to Russell. Russell tries to turn the corner. He stops, gets 1 yard as he dives. There's a flag down. Is it a face mask or a clip? There's a look like it's against the Jay Mustangs, and it is, as referee John Barnett pointed an accusing finger. The accusation is a deposition of penalty against the Jay Mustangs. 15 yards. Here we go. It's down to the 14-yard line. First and 10. Chastang comes back in along with Milton McKenzie. Coming out, Clifford Wallace. Out of the huddle they come. Over the ball is Ted Gerner, the 5'10", 175-pound senior. Hold on to your hats, everybody. Don't bite your nails yet. We've got 3 quarters to go. First quarter is nearing an end. Jay 7-0 over the Huskies. But the Holmes boys have a drive going. They're beginning to bark again. Maldonado sets them. Pitches back to Lawson. He slips and falls in the backfield. And Lawrence is there to make sure he can't get up and go. And that was Gerald Lawrence making a hit on him. That's a loss, a big loss of maybe 4 yards, and that hurt the Holmes Husky cause.
Oh, yeah, and on first down, you need that 4, 5, 6 yard gain. In this case, they got the 4 yard loss. So now it's second long yardage, and they're going to have to try something good outside or maybe throw the ball on a fake.
Less than 40 seconds to go. McKenzie splits wide to the left. Wide to the right is Jerry Robinault. Maldonado back to pass. He rolls to his left. He looks. He throws it in the end zone. There's a man. It's complete at the 4-yard line. A little down and out pattern. It's a flag pattern, actually. And making the stop is Scott Thomas, making the catch, Milton McKenzie. First and goal with time running out in the first period. 33 seconds left. 23 seconds. Mm-hmm. Counting now. First and goal inside the 5.
Gary, he needed 14 yards, and he got 14 yards and 2 inches. A beautiful pass.
It's at about the 4-yard line. Maldonado, the all-district wide receiver, now at quarterback. Here's the handoff and the dive, and it goes to Lawson. He goes over right guard, getting a block from Ligon and Westbrook, but he's short. That's the end of the first quarter. Our score after one period of play from Northside Stadium, John Jay, 7, Oliver Wendell Holmes, 0.
Ladies and gentlemen, under the big top, Shatoff, annual big tent sale. In the center ring, everything goes, from Frigidaire to Frederick, the biggest bargain deal of 1980. The Shatoffs sell at all event at 1134 West Hildebrand. If you wanted to supply your home with a new appliance but felt you just couldn't afford it, now is your opportunity to find the best quality at the lowest possible price. Curtis Mathis television sets, tagged to sell. Let your budget be your guide. Microwaves, freezers, refrigerators. You need it, they've got it. There's no clowning around at Shatoff during the annual big tent sale at 1134 West Hildebrand.
Three ring circus right here. We've got the spotlight focused at center ring. We're at the 1 yard line. Here come the Huskies. Actually, Barry, I think it's closer to the two, about the 1.5. But the Huskies are fired up and ready to go. Harvey Harper bringing you the second period. Harvey Harper used cars, 59-59 San Pedro. And right now, the Holmes Huskies have their machine well-tuned, full house backfield. Maldonado turns, gives it off to Lawson. Touchdown, Holmes! Diving over left tackle. Richard Gonzalez, Gurner, and Bonugli making brilliant blocks over there, firing out. And they have gone to within one now, 7-6 here in the first moments of the second quarter.
And there wasn't anything fancy about that play, just straight up the middle.
It was a good try for the extra point. And with the extra point, the Holmes Huskies tied it up 7-7. Now, back to the play-by-play with Barry Robinson and Gary DeLaune.
We would have a Donnybrook going here at Northside Stadium where at least 13,000 fans will be witness to that fact. And our testimony will be on KMFM.
You're talking about the ultimate time-consuming, ground-oriented drive. Holmes passed only two times, used 13 plays to go those 81 yards, and they must have ran off almost half that first quarter.
And we're ready to go with the kickoff. It'll be Hawkins, the man with a talented toe, and we've got that jet speed again ready to take it. Ball's placed at the 40-yard line, and here's the kick, and it's a squibber. Picked up by Scott Thomas. He drops it. He's at the 20. Falls down at the 22-yard line. Thomas couldn't hang on to it. Picked it up and stumbled at the 22. That's one way to prevent a long run back. The first and 10 now for the Jay Mustangs, as each team has a big seven. Each team has a big record in 1980. What more can you say? John Jay, 2,900 in enrollment, founded 1967. Principal Roger Harrison, his 11th year. He used to be head coach at Brackenridge for the basketball team over there years ago. Out of that they come. The Mustangs have Mike Bowman over the ball. Danny Garza is the man under. Full house backfield now as they use a similar tactic. Here's Garza with a bootleg, pitching it back, and it's to Cole, and he's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. Great pursuit. And who was the man that got him first? It's James Robertson, the yeoman defensive end. A loss of one.
That Holmes defense has studied a lot of films on that one. That was a great fake. I
good
thought they might be coming to the yeah, and it fooled everybody but Holmes defense.
KMFM 96 FM on your dial, San Antonio, your home of high school football, and this is our Culebra Castle of Bumps and Bruises right here, Northside Stadium. Now that they come, it'll be full house backfield. The man with the ball is Bowman. The man under is Garza. Long count. He turns. He gives it off, coming to the near side to Cole. He tries to break outside, and he gets 4 yards, maybe five. Making the stop again is Roberson. At the bottom of the green stack, though, is his cohort, John Bruni, 5'11", 180-pounder. Jeff Havey came up to assist. Gain of four, third and seven. Mark it at the 24.5, call it the 25-yard line. 7-3. Sam Houston trailing Highlands over at Alamo Stadium. 52 defense by the Huskies. Splitting wide is Santiago. Back to pass. It's Garza. He'll look. He'll throw downfield. It's a man open. Oh, what a hit and what a catch. Great catch. Beautiful catch. And slow getting up with it is Ed Solis, the twin to Ray. And what a hit put on him by Danny Gonzalez, 5'7", 165-pound senior. Ed Solis is a 5'9", 155-pound senior. But I mean, that was meat against meat.
Just a vicious hit. That was, by the way, Jay's first pass of the ball game. Holmes now has a 8-4 lead in first down.
At the 39-yard line, first and 10 in Mustang territory, their own corral. Here is the handoff, goes back to Staten. Staten cuts outside. He's to the 45, the 50, down to the 45, and down at the 40-yard line. Tony Staten managed to do-si-do and jogged his way into the secondary before he's run out of bounds by Jimmy Hawkins, and that's
at the 43-yard line, first and 10, as the fireworks are heading toward the goal line again. And we've got a timeout call by the Holmes Huskies with timeout on the field. Our score is J7. Holmes, no timeout. Okay, we won't break away. Period. There are so many people in here tonight, you couldn't get a toothpick and a can of sardines. 10 minutes left to play in the second quarter, 7-7 at Alamo Stadium. It's 7 for Highlands and 3 for Sam Houston. L.G. Henderson, what more can you say about the veteran that are halfback and quarterback at Cameron, Oklahoma, New Mexico State? Here we go, back to play. Gears up, puts Cole in motion. Long count. Overbalance to the left, and he wants to roll to his right. Over, and he gets the flow. He fumbles the ball, and he dives for it. And he's got it at the 40. That was just that play just never took off from the start. It didn't fool anybody. It was a long count, and Cole was in motion. It looked like it was a slow motion replay.
It was. Cole was in motion. I'm not sure if he was supposed to be, but it was so obvious he had to almost just start jogging in place because somebody didn't want him to be there, or he was there too early. I'm not sure what.
It was like he was marking time in place. And they gained a yard only on the fumble. Boy, that was almost disaster. Out of the huddle they come. The wide to the right is Santiago as the slot man. The line is tight. Here's the handoff, and it comes to the near side to Cole. He gets 3 yards before at the bottom of the green stack is Mario Raymond. And he gets a big assist over there by Kenny Hayes, the young sophomore playing in a pressure game for that youngster. 3rd and 4. Mark it at the Holmes 38-yard line and 37 now. And what a key play in this drive.
And for Ansel Cole now, Gary, we have 4 carries for 103 yards. Of course, 95 of that came on the touchdown run.
Garza brings him out, over balance to the right. Now he's back. He jogs somebody. Here goes back to Cole on a bad play, and he may have picked up the first down even on a play that didn't go anyplace. It didn't work. His fullback hit him as he tried to hand off, and that could bring up 4th and about 1 or less. Just the sheer speed of Cole before he stopped by Galloway, Bruni, and Habe. As we go to Greg.
All right, referee John Barnett indicated that they do have a 4th down situation. He had called for the change at first, but then realized that they still had at least a yard. It's 4th and 1 for the Jay Mustangs midway through the second period.
Mississippi Gambler time. They're going to go for it at the 34-yard line. Lined up in the power right of the right. Here's the turn, the handoff, and first down for Anthony Beverly. It was to Cole, Beverly blocking. He just followed the hip of Cole over right guard, and he got the first down. Habe makes the stop, but it's elementary.
And he was actually hit at the line of scrimmage, but he is so tall, so powerful, he just drove through the tacklers with his leg, picked up 3 yards.
It's 1st and 10 at the 31-yard line. Now the Mustangs have their galloping shoes on. Full house backfield. Garza looks over that 43 defense. Turns the counter. It goes to Santiago, and he's hit behind the line of scrimmage in a 43 charge. And who is it? The biggest Husky on the field, Richard Galloway, 6'4", 250. He bench pressed 350. That time he had all of his muscle in one place. And he threw young Mr. Santiago for a yard loss. It'll be 2nd and 11. Time is ticking away, and we have somewhere around 6 minutes to play in the second quarter. It's 7-7. At Alamo Stadium, it's 7-3. Highlands over Sam Houston. Andy Poland is over there and will keep us informed of all developments. Out of huddle they come. Over the ball, Bowman. And there's illegal procedure or delay of game, one of the two. Delay of game, I believe, is the call against the Mustangs. Play was late in developing. Delay of game. That brings up a 5-yard walk-off back to the 38-yard line. So now it'll be 2nd and 16. 7 minutes to play in the second quarter. 7-7. Garza raced over to get a play from L.G. Henderson, who has three children all in the coaching business. Butch at Borger, Cooper at Perryton, and daughter Linda is head coach at Seminole for women's athletics. Out of that way come now. Here is Garza. Bootleg to the left. He wants to throw. He is being pressured. He is being chased. And then smothered by Galloway.
back at the 45-yard line. The biggest Husky certainly had a bite to go with his bike on that play. The big 250-pound lad was in on the tackle.
And David Garza, I believe, felt like he probably was 600-something pounds. All 250 pounds of Galloway fell on Garza.
Well, what happens when you cross a Husky with a Mustang? You get a barking pony.
A barking pony.
And I'll put that in the stable and save it. Out of that will they come. The Mustangs have a third and about 23 yards to go. It's back at the 45, and somebody moved. Offsides are illegal procedure. It's against the Mustangs, and now they've lost their poise. Back to the 49. Delay of game again. Well, they've lost a cog in the machine right now.
Yes, with
third and 29.
This particular set here, when it started, they had a first down at 31, and now they're back to midfield.
Long yardage to go. At Staten is now in. We watch a long bomb. That's going to be the call. Cole is in the slot. Here's back to pass is Garza. He wants to unload all the distance. He throws downfield. Intercepted by Holmes. Intercepting in the secondary is Donald Johnson, the linebacker who trailed the play and got in front of the intended receiver. I believe it was Thomas. First and 10 for the Huskies at the Holmes 42-yard line. Big play defensively. But when the Mustangs lost their poise, they couldn't make noise. And they gave up the football. Out of the huddle come the Huskies, and now they have the opportunity. Wide to the right, McKenzie. Out and out of the man under. Overbalanced to the left. Here's the turn, the give, and it fakes, and it goes to Russell, and he booms his way into the secondary for 5 quick yards. Making the stop over there is Anthony Beverly. And it's a gain of maybe 5, as Ed Solis also in on the play. Call it 4.5. It'll be second and a long 5.5.
Most high school football fans have heard so much about Lawson, Staten, Beverly, Cole, great running back. This Russell kid is outstanding running back. There, he's hit at the line of scrimmage, just spurts out and gets 4 or 5 yards.
McKenzie and Robinot split wide to the left, the tandem set. Here's the handoff, and it comes to Lawson. He has no place to go as they slam the door on him. And making the stop is Lawrence, the leading tackler from that left linebacking side in the 52 defense for coach L.G. Burr Henderson. We've got 5 minutes left to play, 7-7 tie. Gary Molesky coached for several years at Foxside, Arkansas. Where he was 29-13-1. Then at Kennedy High School, he was 41-28-1. Quite a record. Coach of the year in 1972. Out of the huddle they come again. Over the ball. Gerner, here's Maldonado keeping, pitching it back. It goes to Lawson. He cuts way and gets to the 49, a 50-yard line. Still plowing, still churning, generating his way forward in the secondary. It's going to be short of the first down. A horde of white-clad Mustangs, should we say a thundering herd of defenders, made the stop. Winnegar, Solis, Flores. Fourth and about a half yard to go. The punting unit comes in, holding his left arm as if it were shaken up a little bit, but he's okay now, was Mike Frisky. He's all right. So it'll be Hawkins doing the punting. Will he fake it or will he kick it?
I bet you he tries to kick it out of bounds, so there will not be a return.
He gets the snap. He's going to try. He almost ran, and here is another beautiful kick. Waiting for it at the 12-yard line. And taking it up is Staten. Cuts inside, cuts outside, and he's back to the 20, the 23-yard line. About a 9-yard return. Before he's stopped by Robertson downfield. 4 minutes to play here in the second quarter, 7-7. Again, the Mustangs have held, and they go to the attack after the interception by Holmes. So Gary Molesky playing conservatively. Harvey Harper bringing you this second quarter of action from Northside Stadium, where around 13,000, a record crowd for this edifice. Here's the turn, here's the give, and it comes outside to Cole, and he gets by from one man. He's still on his feet, gets maybe 4 yards. Having him trapped in the backfield was John Bruni, but he couldn't hang on as he gave him a scatter step and raced up for maybe 4 yards. He would have had a 3 or 4 yard loss. Instead, he gained 4.
I don't think there's a running back in this game tonight who can be tackled by one defensive player. We have so many great running backs, you can't get them one-on-one.
4 minutes to play in the second quarter, 7-7, full house backfield. Now here's Staten in motion. Here's the pitch back to Staten to the 25. Cuts outside to the 30. Still on his feet at the 33. Fumbles, and I believe Holmes has got it. Yes. All right, we're going to give two guys credit. Kevin Gutchess and Donald Johnson. They were both there, and they caused the fumble. And Staten, trying to cut outside, could not go in the second consecutive turnover, and the Huskies have taken over. Out of the huddle and over the ball is Ted Gurner, a 5'10", 175-pound senior. 3 minutes to play in the second quarter, 7-7. Wide to the left comes Milton McKenzie. Maldonado has him overbalanced to the right. He rolls out to his left. He wants to throw. He fires a long bomb downfield. There's a man wide open. Touchdown, home to Milton McKenzie. 31-yard pass play. Beautifully thrown. Well received. Touchdown.
And the extra point was good. With that, Holmes took a 14-7 lead over John Jay. Gary DeLaune describes the kickoff as Jay suffers through a miscue.
Cole was looking to go outside, and he cut inside and fumbled it, and Riemann came up with it. Here we go, first and 10 at the 35-yard line. Maldonado is the man under. He turns, he fakes, he wants to keep. He decides he's being thrown by a loss, and it's Anthony Beverly who takes the ball away from him, but the ball's whistled dead. In there, defensively, now the Mustangs are fired up as they want to get that ball back. And also in on the play, Beverly, Lawrence, and Mark Douglas.
By the way, with that last touchdown, the officials informed us there was 2 minutes, 57 seconds left, so there should be about 2 minutes left now, and Jay needs to stop Holmes from getting in the end zone and getting two touchdowns ahead.
Well, or even a three-pointer, because Jimmy Hawkins can kick a 40-yard field goal with no sweat. Out of the middle they come. They lost four on the last play. Maldonado wants to pass. He gets pressure. He wants to throw. He does. He fires. It's complete. And now at the 15-yard line to Calvin Chastang, a 5'9", 165-pounder. Scott Thomas makes the stop. He ejected the canopy and pulled the cord. 2 minutes to play. At the 14-yard line, the Holmes Huskies are out of the doghouse now. They're in the stables of the Mustangs of John Jay. Wide to the left is Milton McKenzie. Slot man inside is Mike Briskey.
And I tell you what, a lot of teams might not know how good this Maldonado kid can throw the football. He's thrown two now, just bullet, 20 and 30 yards on the line. Beautiful pass.
Overbalance to the left. Here we go. He pitches it back. It comes to Lawson. Lawson cuts to the outside. He's down at the 15 and out of bounds at the 15-yard line. Actually, about the 11-yard line. Tried to turn on the speed. And he couldn't do it. Scott Thomas defending with Ed Solis. So that's a gain of maybe a yard, maybe two. They say he's going to be out of bounds at about the 12.
And he did do a good job of getting to the sideline, stopping the clock.
Keith Lawson, Greg Russell are the running backs. Gurner's the man over the ball. He's the first out of the huddle for the Holmes Huskies, driving to our left now, which is the north. 13,000 fans on their feet. Full house backfield. Here's the fake, and here goes the handoff to Wallace. He cuts inside to the 10, to the 5, to the 4, to the 3-yard line! Maybe the 2! There's a young man who hasn't carried very many times. 62 coming into this ball game. He's all the way down to the 2-yard line. It's Clifford Wallace, 333 yards. 185-pound senior. He's a junior, and we've got a timeout called by the Holmes Huskies. Timeout on the field. Our score is Holmes 14, John Jay 7. We'll tell you, this quarter is brought to you by Harvey Harper, 5959 San Pedro, serving San Antonians 25 years on that street. We've got a dandy brewing right here at Northside Stadium, the biggest crowd in Northside Stadium history.
That, by the way, was the first carry of this game for Wallace, and a big one it was on a 2nd and 8. He picks up 10. Now they got the ball on the 2-yard line and can easily get in there for a score that could make it 21-7 at halftime.
Holmes opened its season with a 27-0 win over Mack, 23-0 over Jeff, 46-0 over Edison, 48-0 over Memorial, 12-7 over Del Rio, 26-14 over Clark, 34-0 over Kennedy, 41-6 over Edgewood, 26-3 over John Marshall. Right now it's 14-7 over John Jay. Gary Molesky, the little guy from Edgewood who played for Tommy Maddox, has got him fired up for this ball game. Out of the huddle they come. First and goal at the 2-yard line. Hold on to your hat. Maldonado has him down. He turns, gives it off to Lawson. He dives. Touchdown!
Keith Lawson has leaped into the end zone. Touchdown for the big gold and green. 20-7 is our tally.
The extra point, once again, was good. And the score, Holmes 21, John Jay 7. Gary DeLaune describes the next kickoff. Once again, Jay has trouble getting a handle on the ball.
It's a fumble by Jay. I believe Holmes has got it again. Holmes has recovered. Getting up off the ball with it. Kenny Hayes, the young sophomore, playing his most important game in his high school career. He may never have another one like this. Out of the huddle come the Huskies. They have it at the J 40-yard line. Don't go away. McKenzie, recipient of a touchdown pass, split wide to the left. Maldonado has Gunner over the ball. Here he is, back to pass. He's bringing pressure. He is being smothered and swarmed under at the 48. Good pursuit. Mike Blake makes the initial hit. Timeout is going to be called, I believe, by... Are they going to go for it? Let's see. No timeout yet. But it's back to the 46. Loss of six on the play. Time is ticking away rapidly. We don't know for sure how much time left. 21-7. Gurner over the ball. McKenzie splits wide to the left. Frisky wide to the right. Maldonado may go to the air here. 52 defense. Now it's a seven-man front. Here is Maldonado. Here's the draw to Lawson. It's to Russell. He breaks free one man and needs 2 yards, and that's all. He's hit hard, and making the stop is Winiger and Beverly and Santiago. So that's third. He gained one. Third and 15 at the 45. May they gamble here? I don't know. Greg Russell checks back. It's not Russell. It's Calvin Chastain.
I tell you, Gary, Jay, just as good as their offense is, they cannot afford to give up another touchdown. If they get three touchdowns behind, that Holmes defense, a good one, can play more conservatively
less,
in the second
less
half.
Less than 30 seconds, Bear, left to go. Maldonado will go to the air. I said, here he is, pitching it back to Lawson. He gets three. The fourth down, they'll punt. Woo! As it happened here. 21-7 is our tally.
The last four times Jay has touched the football, it has turned it over. Three times on fumbles and four times before this on a pass interception.
That's the half. After two quarters of play from jam-packed Woodside Stadium, Holmes 21, Jay 7. Ready to go, and this time it's Jay kicking off to open the third quarter. And we have Wallace is on the near side, Lawson on the far side. And here's the kick, and it's going to go to Lawson's side. He takes it at the 25, cuts inside, outside. He's to the 35, the 40. He breaks it to the 45 and down at that point. Boy, another block, and he would have been off to the races. And he would have had a starting gate at Ruidoso at the 44-yard line, first and 10, as Richie Gaddison made the stop for the J Mustangs.
And that's a good point, Gary. One more block, Lawson would have been gone, possibly making it 28-7, and that's the pressure on Jay now. They can't afford to let Holmes block him one more time. They can't get one more touchdown behind.
Chastain wide to the left. Here is Maldonado. He keeps. He gets 3 yards, maybe 2.5, really. Lawrence makes the stop, but also there is Steve Kopp and Roger Flores, 180-pound sophomore, starting in that forward wall.
Gary, I have with me Marv Gustafson. And Gus, you've got quite a large crowd here. Is this the largest you've ever had?
Greg, I'm sure this is the largest crowd we've had since I've been here. And the people that have been here longer than I have said it's the largest they've ever seen. So I'm sure it's the largest crowd we've ever had at Northside.
Ready to go back to play. It's second and 8. Here's the handoff, and it goes to Greg Russell. And he gets 3 quick steps over right guard, right tackle, before Anthony Beverly's there to make the stop. And also Flores again. So it's going to be 3rd and 5. They must go to the 46-yard line in Mustang territory for the first down.
What's your unofficial total at this point?
Well, it's about 14,540 is the unofficial account. So it's in that neighborhood.
They got about 4,000 sitting in the end zone.
Well, at least. Yeah, we sold about 4,000 tickets tonight, standing room only, and we'd already sold 1,100.
Maldonado keeps it. Maldonado will be stopped short of the first down. Making the stop. Mark Douglas. So it'll be 4th and punt
and the Mustangs have held on their first thrust by the Holmes Huskies here in the third stanza. Gus forgot to count those 23 guys in the restroom. They missed them.
I think some might still be coming in.
Well, we see a couple of cars straggling in at the parking lot, but nobody's leaving, that's for sure. And it means Jimmy Hawkins will be back to do the punting. And a triple safety for the Mustangs. You've got Santiago, Holmes, and Staten. Aretha Cole. It's going to go to Staten at the 14. Goes to the outside. He's to the 20, the 25. He's up to the 30, to the 32-yard line. 33. And that is why they are so dangerous at all times. Tony Staten, almost as fast as Ansel Cole. It's like having two jets at your disposal at the end of the runway. First and 10 at the 34-yard line. Ready to go now. Here come the Mustangs out of their own corral. Sitting Santiago wide to the right. Cole is the tailback. Here's a roll out to the left by Garza. He gets 4 yards, maybe three, as hitting him low is Galloway. And also there is James Robertson, along with Jeff Habe. Gain of three, second and seven. Mark it to the 37-yard line. 21-7 is our tally from Northside Stadium. Holmes leading, but the Mustangs have the ball. In the slot to the left is Cole. He comes in motion to the near side. Here it is to Cole. He comes to the outside to the 35, gets to the 40, and almost breaks it at the 44-yard line. Should be enough for a first down. Making the stop again is Donald Johnson, along with Kevin Gutchess. The ball is in order. It is close to the first down, and they're going to bring in the chain gang.
Yeah,
this quarter is brought to you by Northern Hills Bank.
That's extremely close for the first down. Again, to go back to the situation with Jay, Gary, that pressure is really going to show now. If they can go down and score, they'll be right back in the ball game within a touchdown from being in it. But there's pressure to score every time they get the ball with only two quarters left.
It's going to be short. About 6 to 7 inches short, says referee John Barnett, Mike O'Grady, Wayman Lightfoot, Fred Granberry, Bob Gundeman, timer Ken Dugosh, our officials tonight, the men in the zebra suits. Found some people in this crowd tonight, just interested spectators, Waylon and Deanne Simmons here. And said they just came to see a good football game, and that they're saying. In motion is Cole. Here's the fake and the handoff straight up the middle to Beverly. Beverly dives for about 6 yards, down to the 50-yard line. From the 43 to the 50, Jeff Habe makes the stop, but that's a first and 10. As he needed 7 inches, he got 7 yards. Hope you enjoy our verbal view over KMFM 96 on your FM dial in San Antonio. Tomorrow night, Lee Churchill. Full house backfield. Here is Garza. Gives it off to Staten. Cuts to the outside. He's being trimmed in, but he gets to the 50. He's at the 45. He's at the 40, the 35. He's at the 30. Cuts inside of the 30. The 25, the 20. He's going to go all the way for a touchdown. With 5 minutes left in the quarter, Tony Staten has just scampered 50 yards for a Jay touchdown.
And that's where that blazing speed comes in, Gary. Good defense by Holmes when they had him pinned up on the sideline. And he cut back against the grain in two or three different angles and got back to the wide open field, and nobody catches Staten when he gets in the wide open.
He jumped the track and headed for the siding. And the Holmes Huskies have been electrified here with a 50-yard run off the fleet feet of Tony Staten. What great speed they've got in the backfield. 21-13.
Clay kicks the extra point, making it Jay 14, Holmes 21. Gary DeLaune picks up the action of the play-by-play.
Again, that little quick down and in. Maldonado simply faked the run, found Frisky, and the young man who had played for Antonian basketball team transferred over to Holmes and has been a welcome addition. Big surprise for Gary Molesky. First and 10 at the 48-yard line. Wide to the left comes Jerry Robineau. Here is Maldonado pitching it back to Lawson. Lawson gets a block. He's to the 50. He gets to the 45. He's to the 40. And down at the 40, the 39-yard line. Keith Lawson stopped by Anthony Beverly and Richard Latta. He pulled the lever and stuffed the ballot box with 7 minutes to go. First and 10 at the 40-yard line. Keith Lawson showing a little bit of his dipsy-doo. 908 yards coming into this ball game.
And that's two first downs, two consecutive first now, downs now for the Holmes offense that might be gaining back some of that momentum.
Well, they've got the confidence to move the ball. Chastain wide to the right, over bounce to the right. 18 yards in from the near side. Here's Maldonado. He throws. It's complete to Chastain. He's at the 20. He's at the 15. He's at the 10. He's at the 5-yard line. Cut from behind at the 5. And making the stop is Fred Winiger. Caught him from behind at the 5-yard line. A quick down and in pattern. He was off to the races again.
And once again, we saw the value, Gary, the play action pass. He faked inside. Throws those linebackers for a split second, pop the ball over the middle. He was wide open, almost busted loose for the touchdown.
It's at the 7. First and goal. Maldonado brings him out full house backfield. He sets him down. Here's the handoff to Russell. He stopped at the 11-yard line. Great ankle-high tackle. And it's Tommy Moten, the offensive left tackle, who is in there defensively now. Tommy's a 202-pound senior. 6 minutes to play. It's second and goal from the 10. Loss on the play. And 14,500 fans are mostly on their feet. Ready to go. Maldonado brings them out. It's an eight-man front thrown up by the Mustangs. Maldonado will look for the pass. He fakes. He rolls out to his right. He looks into the end zone. A Lawson pass. I believe it's intercepted. Intercepted by Jay. There could have been interference, but no flag fell.
Yeah, the Holmes bench, the coaches, and of course the fans on this side of the stadium were really yelling for interference. As everybody was going up, the Holmes receiver went down. Obviously somebody stepped on somebody's foot. I guess they figured it was accident, no flag.
So it's first and 10 from the 1-yard line. Gary, that ball is marked inside the 1-yard line. 99 yards to go on a first down for John Jay. Here's the quick handoff. It's a keep, actually, by Danny Garza. And here, everybody in the stands is thinking Cole right now.
Well, you called the play on the last time they were down there, Gary. About the time you said it, he went 95 yards.
And we're ready to go. It's second and 9 from the 2. Time ticking away, third period, 21-14. What an electrifying game this has been. Garza brings him out at the 2-yard line. He gives it off to Beverly, and he stopped at the 2. A gang tackle job led there by Habey, the first man to get to it, John Bruni. So it'll be 3rd and 8. 5 minutes to go in the quarter. 21-14, Holmes. 3rd down and long.
Well, if Jay ever needed a first down, it's right now. Back here on its own 3-yard line. If it would have to punt, Holmes would have great field position in Jay territory.
Straight and wide to the right. Watch for the fly pattern. Here is the fake. Here he goes, and it's falling down. Is Beverly a draw straight up the middle to the 18, 1st and 10. He had plenty of daylight ahead of him, but he simply fell at the 18. Nobody touched him.
Really surprising. As you pointed out, nobody touched him for the first 10 yards, and actually till he slipped down. A big hole.
Neither team has been able to stop the other. 1st and 10 at the 18. This quarter brought to you by Northern Hills Bank. 3 minutes to play, we think. Here's the handoff. Comes to Cole. He comes to the outside, and he almost breaks at the 24, but he slips and falls again. To the 24-yard line. Gain of 5. 2nd and 5. Bruni is there. It's 4 minutes to play now in the quarter. Well, as we told you earlier, the clock is not functioning. 2nd and 4. Gain of 6. Jay on the move again. Staten wide to the right. Always a threat. They have to drop somebody out there to watch for him. Cole and Beverly are the running backs. Garza is the man under. He turns. He gives it off to Beverly. And he is being stopped for a yard loss as flags fly. It's either a face mask or holding in the forward wall. Brent Silver says illegal procedure against the Mustangs. They may decide to take it. It's 21-14. Less than 3.5 minutes to go in the third period. Holmes leading. They've been unable to score here in the third quarter. 50-yard run by Tony Staten. It is a 5-yard walk-off, illegal procedure against the Mustangs. We have not had Andy Poland's report yet. If Andy's listening, he'll come in a moment to tell us what's going on at Alamo.
Gary, we have just come to the end of the third quarter. Sam Houston has put on an excellent display of both defense and ball control. They continue to lead the game 9-7 as we begin the fourth quarter of play, and Highlands has got to get something going or else they will be upset.
Staten is stopped by, again, a game tackling job led by Galloway and Raymond. So that brings up third and six. And Holmes is trying to contain that great speed with 3 minutes to play in the quarter. Andy Pollan on hand at Alamo to keep us informed as they begin the fourth quarter over there. Stay tuned. Greg Simmons is on the sideline. Here we go. This is the key play right here. He's giving it off to Cole. He stops short of the first down. Gain of three. And there's Habe and Galloway and Raymond. John Bruni from the left side defensively. KMFM 96 on your FM dial, San Antonio, fourth and punt with fourth and two. I don't think LG Henderson will gamble this deep in his territory at the 26. If he does, he would be a bigger gambler than I anticipate he would be, and it's going to be a punt time as Anthony Beverly, averaging about 35 yards a kick, will be kicking from his own 12-yard line. Going deep, we've got Clifford Wallace.
There's a bad snap. It's going to go to the end zone. Beverly will try to get it out. Beverly runs with it. He throws a pass. It's complete. And it's to the 20, to the 25, to the 30. It could be a first down. Is there a flag or not? No flag.
That looked like some kind of big lineman who caught the football, Gary. The Holmes coaching staff is really screaming. Illegal lineman downfield, I think.
All right, I'm down here in the middle of this melee, and what they're arguing about is where the point of the ball should be marked. They're going to have to call a changeover simply because it's going to be too close to call from this side. The chains are on the opposite side of the field, and what the coaches were upset about, they felt he stepped out of bounds about a couple of yards earlier. John Barnett, the referee right here, is calling for the chains, and it is marked presently at the 29-yard line. The nose of the ball is at the 29-yard line. It's going to be close enough to measure. What a break this could be for John Jay. Let's see. We'll stretch the chain. We're right here on the sidelines with it, and it's good by at least a length and a half of the football. A length and a half of the football, and that is upsetting to the Holmes coaches. They are protesting vociferously here on the sideline. Jay picking up an important first down here late in the third quarter.
Oh, that was a lot of luck. No doubt about that.
Oh,
that was sheer luck.
You know, Jerry, he threw that football left-handed. He might be left-handed, but...
And Blake happened to be the man of the hour. Mike Blake caught it. He was not an illegal lineman. He just simply was alert.
It really is incredible that they did not have a lineman downfield. It was a full, 4 or 5 seconds after the snap.
What a brilliant break for the Jay Mustangs. Full house backfield. Here we go. Here's the fake and a handoff. And it's to Beverly, and he plows his way forward, churning, spinning, sapping into the secondary. Gain of five. 2 minutes to play in the third quarter. Second and call it four. Out of the huddle they come. Cole is the slot man to the left. Here is the handoff that goes to Santiago. He breaks it outside to the 46-yard line. Maybe to the 47. Well, it seems right now that play fired up the Mustangs, and they had the momentum. About a minute to play in the quarter, 21-14. If the Mustangs go in here, KD by the door.
Yeah, that would really be the momentum in their favor. Some incredible good luck on this series here. The Holmes defense should be, probably is, looks like it's a little bit down now.
Yes, it is. And here's the handoff, and it comes outside to Cole. Here he comes, and he stopped behind the line, but he gets back to the line of scrimmage. Good play, saving a long gain, and making the stop is Mario Riemann. Third and about a half yard. Wow, talk about excitement.
We now have Cole with 127 yards on 10 carries.
15 seconds, they may not get this play away. They may not get it away with about 8 seconds to go. Three, two, one. And that should be the end of the third quarter, and is. After three periods of play from Northside Stadium, our score is Holmes 21, Jay 14.
At Alamo Stadium, Andy Pollan reporting on the Sam Houston Highlands game. Our score remains Sam Houston 9, Highlands 7. The Cherokees continue to play great defense, and they have controlled the football on offense.
What a big upset. The city's top-ranked team trailing right now, Sam Houston.
And wouldn't that be an amazing turnaround, having lost the first three games of the season?
The Mustangs on the move again. Here's the fake and the handoff to Beverly. He stopped behind the line, and he's going to be swarmed under, bringing up fourth and four. Great play. What a swarming Holmes Husky defense. Galloway and Kenny Hayes and John Bruni. Handy Dan bringing you this fourth and final period. Handy Dan, your do-it-yourself headquarters. Fourth and call it three. Are they going to gamble here or punt it away, Barry?
Oh, they better punt the football. They've had one, you know, they might pick up a first down on the punt they did last time. You can't gamble now, though. Early in the fourth quarter, only one touchdown behind.
At the 46-yard line, they'll punt. Beverly will kick it. Here's the snap. The rush is on. It's away, and no flag. It's all in order. Here's the picked up at the last minute by the young man at the 30. Comes at the 35. He's at the 40 to the 45-yard line. All the way upfield, and the speedster for the Holmes Huskies racing downfield is Jimmy Hawkins, the all-district kicker. Ronnie Touch made the stop for the Mustangs, saving perhaps another 40 yards. That was a dangerous play. They're bringing it back, however. It looked like a clip on the far side. He went out of bounds over there. Down for the Mustangs, but I don't believe he's too seriously hurt, is Tommy Moten, the big offensive tackle. They're bringing it all the way back to the 10-yard line. Now they say it's down at the 21. 26. It was a flag, was it not? Or did he step out of bounds? The flag is down where he stepped out. That's the call. All right. It'll be first and 10 at the 26-yard line. But I tell you, Jimmy Hawkins really caused the hearts to stop just for a second. First and 10.
He did that. And also, after the punt, by the way, Beverly punts left-footed. He limped off the field. He looked like, I don't know if he...
When he came down, I noticed that he favored his left foot.
Might have turned an ankle.
Here's Maldonado. He turns. He gives it off. It comes to Russell. Russell scatter steps. He comes inside to the 27-yard line. He gains maybe a yard. Ran a lot of yardage, but stopped by Santiago and by Gerald Lawrence. And Lawrence is slow getting up, rather Russell, but he's okay. Greg Russell coming into this ball game had 737 yards rushing. He has 4-6 feet in the 40. He has a 13-8 in the high hurdles. Beverly is back in, so he's okay defensively. McKenzie is out now. That's split in for Holmes. Full house backfield. Maldonado, he turns, gives it off to Lawson. Lawson crosses the 31-yard line to the 32. Winninger's there to make the stop at the bottom of the big blue stack. Blocking, getting a good block from Ted Gunner, the center, 175-pound senior. But it's going to be third and the long three. Very important play defensively as Chastang checks in with a play from Coach Gary Molesky. Gary Molesky, whose grandparents came from Poland near Warsaw. Gary Brown Molesky is his name. Hobbies are fishing and golf. His son, by the way, plays for Kitty Hawk. He's a quarterback. We'll be playing for Judson next year. Here's the fake and the handoff, and it comes to Russell. He's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage, and he's short of the first down punt time. We've got 10 minutes to play in the ball game. Steve Kopp makes the stop. So now, Jimmy Hawkins will again put his toe into battle. And we've got a triple safety again. Scott Thomas, Tony Staten, and Robert Santiago will drop deep. They'll go to their own 30-yard line. Hawkins will be the punter. And he'll stand at his own 20. Nighttime air is a little nippy as the night wears on. And this heated battle on the field. Here's the kick. Another good kick, but not quite as high as the last one. Just taken by Santiago at the 30 and goes to the 42-yard line. And there is a timeout as he goes out of bounds at that point. It will be Jay's ball, first and 10 at the 42. Santiago makes the return, and making the stop is Westbrook along with Clifford Wallace. So the Holmes Huskies, with a little more than 9 minutes to play in the fourth and final period, still hold a 21-14 lead, but the Mustangs have the ball.
And that's good field.
Yes, good field position. Balance line. Here's the fake. Here's the fumble in the backfield, but Staten retains it. As just as he handed off Garza fell, and Staten couldn't go on the counter, and he stopped behind the line for maybe a yard loss, and making a stop, Mario Riemann and John Bruni, along with Javier Garcia.
Well, this is what the whole season has come down to now, Gary. We're probably about midway in the fourth quarter. Again, the clock is out, but they played the whole season down to this last game, and, you know, this is it. Jay has come back and scored.
9 minutes to play. Jay on the attack. Jay... Here's the handoff, and it goes to the first man, and that's Santiago. That's Beverly, the big fullback, and he gets maybe 2 or 3 yards. Making the stop is, again, Galloway and Robertson, the two big inside men. It's third and 9. Big play here. Less than 9 minutes to go in the ballgame. 21-14 Holmes. Andy, how is it at Alamo?
Our score remains the same, Gary, but Sam Houston in excellent position. They have the football at the 20-yard line of Highland, still hanging on to a 9-7 lead, less than 7 minutes to play.
Here's the play. Here's the handoff to Cole. He goes outside. He's up and away again, and he's close to the first down at midfield, but he's going to be about a yard and a half short. Oh, he's ever so dangerous. Making the stop and saving the long yardage is the little guy, Kenny Hayes, along with Kevin Gutchess. 8 minutes to play. Fourth and one. It's decision time right now.
That's right. I believe they're going to mark the ball. It'll be a little bit closer to two, I believe, Gary. Should be about 8 minutes now. They're going to take time out to think about it.
With timeout on the field, 8 minutes to play in our game, our score is Holmes 21, Jay 14.
Gary, and Anthony Beverly again is getting that muscle massage. He's been having problems with his leg muscles. They've been cramping up on him, but he'll stay in the ballgame defensively for the John Jay Mustang. Now with a little less than 8 minutes to play in this ballgame, Holmes Huskies still on top of John Jay, 21-14.
I believe they're going to go for it, Barry. It looks like. Unless Beverly drops deep, but I believe they're going to go for it.
It certainly looks like it.
We'll see if Beverly drops back or not. No, he's going back into punt formation. Okay, Andy, what's the scene at Alamo?
Same thing, Gary, but Highlands held on fourth and less than a half a yard, so they have the football now at the 21-yard line, trailing 9-7, but they have shown nothing offensively here.
Here's a fake punt, and it passed, and it goes to Cole down to the 20, the 15-yard line. A fake punt. It went to Danny Garza. It went to Cole on the pass, on the fake punt, fourth and two, and that caught Holmes completely asleep, and now it's going to be first and 10 at the 20-yard line. Great play, great call. Well, what do you do? Right here, they're 20 yards away from the tying score. And Jay is on the attack. The Holmes defense had looked for the punt. Here it is. Here's the handoff. And it goes to Cole. Cole to the 20. He falls down at the 18-yard line. Nobody touched him. He simply fell after a gain of two. Second and eight. If the Holmes Huskies ever had a defense, this is the time they must use it. The Jay Mustangs, remembering last year when they trailed by nine? Well, they trailed by 14 with 7 minutes to go in this one. And now it's 21-14, and they have a shot at it to tie it. Out of that, they count. Here's Garza, the man under. He's back to pass instead. He gives it off to Staten. Staten to the 20. He gets to the 15 to the 13-yard line. And there, making the stop, is Bruni and also Galloway and Gutchess. So that brings up third down and three. Third and three at the 13.
Okay, Gary, I have just checked. By getting inside the 20-yard line here, Jay has three penetrations. Holmes has four penetrations. So that's the first thing you consider in place of a tie. Jay has to beat Holmes.
Here's the fake and hand up to Cole. He's got maybe the first down as he dies, I believe, for the first down. Yardage at the 10. It should be enough for the first down, and is. First and goal at the 9. As Cole showed that he has inside power as well as outside speed. Hope you enjoy our fourth period brought to you by Handy Dan on KMFM. And now the Huskies see a first and goal. At the 9-yard line, 6 minutes to play in the game. Thomas, the man in the slot. Garza brings him out. Here's the handoff. It comes to Staten. Fumble! Holmes has got it! And it's Kevin, it's Robertson, and the guy that caused it, I believe, was Donald Johnson.
That's right, Gary, and that could be the biggest play for the Holmes Huskies tonight to preserve a possible victory this evening. They have less than 6 minutes to play in this ballgame, 5:58. But with the explosive power of the John Jay Mustangs, Holmes would be wise to go ahead and get another touchdown on the board at this point.
Well, they might be wise to do it, but of course, Jay may have something to say about it, Gregory, as we go back to play here. Full house backfield. Maldonado brings him out. He turns. He gives it off to Lawson, and Lawson, 5 quick yards. With his fleet feet going for the 20 into the 21-yard line. Gerald Lawrence makes the stop, the leading tackler. Oh, man, what a finale. Center ring, the spotlight is on. The crowds love it. This could be called our anatomical animal house. Ready to go. It's second and 5 at the 21. Maldonado. Offsides against the Huskies, and that will set them back 5 yards as
firing out too quickly is Mike Friska.
And just as importantly, just as much damage to Holmes is the fact that the penalty will stop the clock.
That's true. And it's second and 10 now. It was first and 5. Now it's second and 10. So they have to have a new play from Calvin Chastain. Will Gary Molesky gamble with 5 minutes to play? Will he put it in the air in order to retain possession with the explosive speed of the Jay Mustangs? Will he try to punt it out of there? Second and 10. Here we go. Full house backfield. Man under. Maldonado. He turns. He fakes. Wallace stopped at the line of scrimmage. Good tackle. Ankle high. Making the stop is Richard Latta, the 195-pound senior. Third and 10. Time ticking away. Less than 4.5 now. You begin to feel the static electricity, the excitement, building, the tension. It's building in me. And I'm already standing.
Just think about how it's building down there on that football field. Jay really needs to stop Holmes here to get good field position. Again, it has to beat Holmes. It cannot tie it.
Robinot wide to the right. Here's Maldonado. He's back to pass. He's going to get pressure. He wants to throw. He fires a long one downfield, and it's over the outstretched hands of the intended receiver, Milton McKenzie. Defending was Ed Solis. It was not a good pass, but it was smart because he threw it out of bounds.
Very smart. In a play like that, if you're not positively sure that you can complete the pass, as you pointed out, Gary, don't let them catch it. He did not.
He tried to go too far. If he'd gone maybe short, a little down and in at about the 30, he might have had it. He went long. The time left to play is less than about 4 minutes to play. And it'll be punt time as Hawkins now with another key punt at the 5-yard line. Will he get the pressure? Will they have the return on? Long count, trying to draw them offside. Here's the snap.
It is blocked by Jay. It's recovered by the Mustangs. And it's going to be taken in for a touchdown. No, Blake is out of bounds at the 2-yard line. The kick was blocked, and Blake took it in the air and went to the 2. The punt was blocked by, I don't know, Hawkins made the stop. I don't know who made the block.
I got it, Gary. It was Tommy Moten blocked the ball. He came right through the middle. Nobody touched him, and number 75, Tony Moten, did a great job. Got his left hand on it.
I told you, things could change in such a hurry. Here's Greg.
We're down on the sidelines. The ball is marked at the 1.5-yard line. The 1.5-yard line is where the ball is marked. And we have an official timeout taken at this time.
We got an official timeout.
Here at Alamo Stadium, gentlemen, we have gotten more or less a last-ditch effort here for Highlands. They still trail 9-7. They have the football at their own 18-yard line. There are 4 minutes left to play. 9-7, Sam Houston leading.
4:20 left right here. 4:20 left in the game.
Okay, Gary. Basically, where we stand now, this is a fourth penetration for Jay. So penetrations, unofficially, are tied 4-4. The next step in the tiebreaker to determine the playoff team is first downs. Again, these are unofficial stats, but we now have Holmes leading 15-13 in first downs. If Jay scored here, of course, they would get a first down, which would put them still one behind, but that's how close we are. They would be tied on penetrations. Jay would trail 1 in first downs. If it wanted to go for the tie, then it could gamble that it could come back and get more first downs.
Ken Dugash is keeping time, and he's standing right by Greg Simmons. So Greg knows exactly what time is left, and Greg is going to inform us right now.
Okay, talking to Ken Dugash, and as you said, Gary, they're informing the coaches now about the penetrations, and as Barry pointed out, they're tied at 4 apiece. The next criteria to determine the winner of this ballgame would be first down. Now the next time they'll stop the clock automatically if the ball is not brought in for a touchdown or the ball is not run out of bounds, they will have a 2-minute warning to notify both benches since the stadium clock is not in operation.
You understand that? All right.
That makes sense to me. Greg, if you happen to see the official on the sidelines who is keeping the stats, you might confirm that first down total.
Ready to go. The Mustangs have a golden opportunity to go in right here. Garza brings them out. It's a full house backfield in the power eye. Here's the handoff, and it goes to Cole, and Cole dives. He stopped at the 1-yard line. He did not get in. Gutchess is there to make the stop. Along with Riemann and Bruni. So it'll be second and goal at the 2. Maybe the 1.5. Wow, it's getting tense. Cole is replaced by Santiago. By Scott, it's Scott Thomas, Santiago, and Beverly. Here's the handoff, and it goes to Thomas, and he dives, and he is stopped short of the first down, or the touchdown. He stopped at the half-yard line. And it's Jeff Habe making the stop. third down and goal. It's third and goal. Will they go outside now using their great outside speed? It's on the one-yard line. Cole back in. Scott Thomas, who just carried, is back out. Cole brings in the play from L.G. Henderson. They're trying to go over Ormiston. He's the biggest guy out there. Here's the handoff. It goes to Cole. He dives. He scores. Ansel Cole has just made it 21-20.
And what he did there, he put Mr. Anthony Beverly right in front of Cole, and Beverly went over the line, opened up the hole, and he got the touchdown.
Beverly scored with 3.5 minutes left in the crucial contest, making the score Jay 20, Holmes 21. And since a tie wouldn't do, they needed the win, the Mustangs went for the two-point conversion. It was successful, and the crowd went wild. But this, one of the most exciting quarters in San Antonio schoolboy football, was not over yet. Gary DeLaune excitedly elucidates the play-by-play action of the final 3.5 minutes.
Now here's the kick, and it's coming to the near side, and it's taken by Hawkins. Hawkins cuts inside. He's up to the 33, the 34. There's a fumble. Holmes has retained it. Holmes has got the ball. First and 10 for the Huskies. With about 3 minutes to play.
And this is where it helps to have a kid like Hawkins who can kick that long field goal.
Exactly.
Holmes only needs two or three first downs to possibly get in the field goal range.
Don't forget his foot. Maldonado brings him out. Maldonado back to pass. Maldonado wants to throw. Maldonado cocks and throws. Complete to McKenzie at the 48-yard line. First and 10 for the Huskies of Gary Malesky. What do you say, everybody? What do you do right here? The time is less than 3 minutes. First and 10 at the 48-yard line. Don't forget, Jimmy Hawkins can boot it. Out of the huddle they come. Gurner over the ball. Wide to the left is McKenzie. Wide to the right is Robinoff. Maldonado brings him out. Maldonado sets him down. Maldonado fakes. Maldonado back to pass. Maldonado wants to throw. He's being pressured. He's in the pocket. He's being chased out of the pocket. Flag is down. Here's the pass, and it's complete. And it's to Russell. Russell gets to the 48-yard line in Mustang territory, but I believe there could be a clip or a holding call. It's interference against the Mustangs, is it?
Oh, my gosh, yes. That's going to be a defensive call, Gary. I thought at first they were going to call it offensive holding, but the Holmes players say, no, it will be defensive.
Defensive holding, which is an automatic first down, if indeed that is the call. Ooh, goodness gracious. Andy, quickly.
Gary, Highlands has just picked up a big first down there in midfield. There are 2 minutes, 16 seconds left to play. Sam Houston's still leading 9-7.
2:40 to play here. 15-yard penalty to the 32-yard line. First and 10 for the Holmes Huskies. 2:40 to play. 2:40 left to play in the ball game.
And that is an incredibly
holding.
Big penalty there.
Holding is the call. Defensive holding. Oh, my goodness gracious. McKenzie wide left. Wide right is Robinoff. Here we go. Maldonado brings him out. He gives it off. He falls. He stumbles. He's up. He throws a long bomb downfield. There's a man wide open. It's intercepted in the end zone by Scott Thomas. Jay has retained it. Interception by Jay in the end zone. Scott Thomas comes up with it. That could be the ball game.
That was a sensational catch, Gary, if you wanted to halfway be critical, and you shouldn't, I don't think, in a game like this. Great effort by both teams, but the ball should not have been thrown. Good defense back there, and actually Holmes was in position there to try a 39-yard field goal.
Yes, they were. 2:25 to play. All Jay will have to do now is to kill it, and it'll be over. 14,500 have had the palpitations tonight. We'll go to Andy Poland in just a moment. Keep it right here now, telling you that it's first and 10 at the 20 after that brilliant interception. A game-saving save, perhaps. Here it is. Here's the handoff, and it comes on the quarterback, Keith DeGarza. He leaps over one man, and he's being swarmed under. And a game tackle. Timeout call by James Hawkins, and it will be second down after a two-yard pickup. We've got a timeout on the field. Our score is Jay 22, Holmes 21. We'll be back in just a moment.
With playoff time just around the corner,
it's time out on the field and time in for Northern Hills Bank. We are proud to be bringing you this exciting 1980 high school game of the week. Now, we are also proud to bring you the best and most efficient banking accommodation available on our high school broadcasts. We have 16 drive-in lanes at Northern Hills, a growing commercial department, and providing you with checking, savings, and passbook accounts to give you 5 1/4% maximum interest. Your money makes money, and you just wait on it. We say welcome, neighbor, to the high school game of the week and to our banking family at Northern Hills. Nacogdoches and Thousand Oaks, the friendly back on the hill. 2:17 to play. Here's Andy Poland at Alamo Stadium.
Gary, Sam Houston is just 50 seconds away from wrapping up the District 31-5A title. They have the football at midfield, less than 50 seconds to play in the football game, leading 9-7. All they have to do is run out the clock, and they have won this football game. What an upset.
It really is, Andy. Go ahead and describe a play for us real quick. We still got time out here. What's happening?
Well, there are 50 seconds left on the clock. The football sitting at midfield. Sam Houston has it first down and 10 yards to go. We imagine they'll go for a running play. Highlands has got one timeout.
All right,
left.
Here we are. Back to play, Andy. Here's Garza handing it off to Beverly, and he gets maybe 2 or 3 yards to the 25 from the 22. So it'll be third down and another timeout by Holmes. And we'll keep it right here, and we'll go to Andy again.
Well, it looks like Highlands has called a timeout. 39 seconds left in the football game. The football at the 42-yard line. We'll call it second and 8 for Sam Houston. They need to run out the clock, and they will have wrapped up the District 31-5A title.
Do you realize, Gary, Andy, how similar these two football games are? It almost sounds like we're hearing a play-by-play for our replay.
9-7 over there. It's 22-21 here. I would have never believed it.
Well, I'll tell you, Gary, it has been a great defensive showing on the part of Sam Houston in the second half. Highlands has not been able to move the football. They've tried the passing game. It's been ineffective, and Sam Houston has just been superb all second half.
Third down. Here it is for Jay. Third and about five. Here it is, Garza, giving it off on the reverse to State, and he comes to the near side. He's to the 20, stopped at the line of scrimmage, and it's to the 22-yard line, a loss of two. Fourth down and punt.
A flag went down on the tackle. Might have been face mask, Gary.
It's against Jay.
That will be a big penalty now. Yeah, the penalty should stop the clock. Also, will force a fourth down here.
2 minutes to play in the ballgame. 2 minutes to play. And it's personal foul. Holding against Jay, declined. Fourth down and seven.
10 seconds left here at Alamo Stadium. Third down and 11 for Sam Houston. This could be the final play of the ball game. All the Cherokees need to do is fall on the football, and they will have won this. The celebration has begun on the near sidelines. Sam Houston well supported here tonight. They are in excellent shape to wrap up the 31-5A title there. They just fall on the football, and Highlands will not be able to stop the clock. This football game is over. Sam Houston has upset Highlands by a score of 9-7 here at Alamo Stadium.
Here's Beverly's kick, and it's being taken by Hawkins. He's at the 50, the 45. He breaks to the 40. He's down to the 37-yard line. Jimmy Hawkins and the Holmes Huskies have one last golden opportunity. We've got less than 2 minutes to play. They may have taken all their times out. We don't know. Hawkins limps off the field. It'll be the Huskies' one last chance. Don't forget, if Hawkins is hurt, that talented foot may not be of use.
That's a great return there by Hawkins, Gary. He got the ball back to the 38, which means they are 45 yards in field goal range now. 45-yard field goal.
Less than 2 minutes. Here's the handoff. Maldonado fakes. He wants to keep, and he swung under at the 40. Great defensive play by Lada and Blake. Timeout called by Holmes. That should be their last timeout.
Yes, and that's an important sack for Jay back on the 40-yard line. Now he would be looking at about a 57-yarder.
And I believe that Hawkins is being treated on the near sideline. It looks like he has an injured leg, Greg.
We're going to check on him just as well, but we have 1 minute and 35 seconds remaining in this ballgame. 1 minute and 35, the Holmes to get back on the track. And we'll check on Mr. Hawkins in just a moment.
As you heard from Andy Poland of Alamo, Sam Houston has upset Highlands 9-7. What a dandy. We've got one brewing here on the back burner. All the stove is lighted. The microwave oven is set. The timer is on.
I'm sorry, by the way, Gary. That's only a 2-yard sack. It would still be a 47-yard field goal.
We'll go with you in a minute, Greg. It's second and 12. Maldonado. Back to pass. gets the pressure. He throws.
It is complete and out of bounds at the 30-yard line, close to the first down, but he's short.
All right, Hawkins is not injured. What they're doing, they're stretching him out for the field goal attempt. They're getting suited up and ready for the field goal attempt. Now that they're within range.
Time out to measure.
Officials time out. The ball's inside the 30. They're going to look and see if it's a first down. I'll tell you one thing. I haven't been this nervous in months.
This is really an incredible high school football game. Andy had a fine one out there at Alamo, and this one is going down to the final second.
It's short by about 3 inches. 3 inches short of the first down. But what Highlands needs to get is closer for James Hawkins. Jimmy Hawkins, remember. Holmes I'm talking about. Highlands lost at Alamo. 22-21.
We have four teams going here. It gets sort of confusing.
1:26 to play in the ball game. This one is 22-21. Chastain comes in with a play, replacing Jerry Robinot at split end. And the crowd is on its feet. They haven't sat down the second half. 14,500 people. Chastain wide to the right. 1:26 to play. Here's the fake. Here's Maldonado throwing out of bounds, and that stops the clock. But it's going to be fourth and inches now. Why didn't they go ahead and run for it? I think Gary Molesky was upset with that play.
Maldonado really looks confused over there now. They're sending in a play.
Well, I don't think he should have done that. They have to go for it. It's fourth down.
Yeah, I think he'll go ahead and try to pick up. We're looking right there. You're looking at about a 45-yard field goal. So I think he'll try to pick up the first down, maybe get another two or three short passes.
I think you're right. It's fourth down. He should have gone for it the last time. Here we go. Maldonado has the first down. And that will stop the clock temporarily. He's down to the 25. And now they have time for another play. Robinoff checks out. Chastain in. They move the chains, but they have time to call the play. We've got about a minute to play. Officially, Greg, how much time?
1 minute, Gary. 1 minute. The signal has just been given.
1 minute to play. One minute. Here we go. Maldonado wants to throw. He fires a long bomb downfield. It's complete and out of bounds at the 15-yard line. McKenzie goes out of bounds at the 15-yard line. Everybody, don't you dare go away.
And McKenzie got out of bounds, as you noted. He stops the clock now. Should be about 45 seconds or so left. They're definitely in field goal range.
51 seconds left to play. 51 seconds. Well, the question is, will they have time to get a boot away if they had the opportunity?
Yes, they do have to be very careful here. One, Maldonado has to be careful not to get sacked, because then the clock keeps running. You're losing ground on the field goal. You obviously don't want the turnover, which Holmes suffered a little while ago in a similar situation.
That's at the 16-yard line. Maldonado brings him out over balance to the left. Here he is. Back to pass. He pitches it back to Lawson. He cuts to the outside. He's inside, and it should be close to the first down. Clock is still running. 51, it's down to about 45, 44, 43. Holmes will have to hurry now. Field goal try. They'll have to hurry to get it away. It's going to be a field goal try, and it will be from the 15-yard line. It'll be about a 27-yard try. 23 seconds, 22, 21, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11. The snap, the kick. It is high. It is far. It's good. It's good. Holmes has kicked the field goal to 27 yards. Here's Greg.
This Holmes bench has just got absolutely wild with the field goal. The Huskies have now turned this ball game in their favor with less than 15 seconds to play. The Huskies have an upset in the making here tonight. The J Mustangs have had their dreams dashed. All Holmes has to do is prevent a long run back.
34-yard field goal. Can you believe it?
And Gary, it would have gone 54 yards. The tricky part about that on the previous play, Lawson had tried to put the ball in the middle of the field, but the J defense ran him wide. He ended up going to the left-hand side of the field, and Hawkins had to kick it from an angle, but it was dead center.
Got 6 seconds left. 6 seconds left in this ball game. Holmes has to prevent the run back by John Jay to preserve their victory. 6 seconds left on the clock. 6 seconds.
The 6 seconds remaining made little difference. Jay Staton could not break away on the kickoff return, and the game was over. The Holmes Huskies 24, John Jay, 22. One of the best and most exciting prep contests I have ever seen. I hope you agree.
Young teacher, the subject of schoolgirl fantasy. She wants you so badly, knows what she wants to be. Inside her, there's longing, this girl's an open page. Bookmarking, she's so close now, this girl.